Welcome back. We have long been told that India is a rich country of poor people. There are 1.3 billion of us and counting, and we face serious challenges on our land, water, all our resources. We have to keep growing, keep producing. That's our duty to our people as a country's progress unto itself. But poor of India, a forest reserve in Karnataka, one of the last homes of tigers and elephants in this country and in the world, a place where children go on safaris, where families go on holidays, is being stripped bare from underneath. It's a shockingly open secret. Investigation has shown trucks upon trucks rolling in and rolling out of Banerghatta National Park, steadily denuding it of everything. Photographs of dead animals that they're leaving in their wake show what they're doing. Karnataka has seen the sand mafia strip away its land and beaches, the iron ore mafia sell the state's riches to China and Bellary, and now another mafia is operating to strip away one of its most important green lungs. Next time, think about it. A water crisis hits, drought hits. Who'll remember the thieves who robbed the forest that stores the moisture? Watch this report. Let me all these politicians across party lines to account. Arif Bode, my colleague, with this investigation.
From Bengaluru, your report, NewsX.
Okay, let's open up this conversation. Joining us on the broadcast, S. Prakash, representing the BJP tonight. Nagaraju Yadav, representing the Congress. Anupam Tripathi, an animal rights activist, is joining me in the studio. And Abhiram, TJ, who's the president of the Anti-Graft and Environment Forum in Bengaluru, joining us in just a bit. And my colleague Harish is with us. Harish, take it very seriously, we promise. The BJP is saying, we always take it very seriously and we'll force the government to take it very seriously, we promise. Do you buy any of them?
I buy both of them. So they speak that the Congress is speaking now because they're in the government.
Yes.
This is their language. This is normally their language. Because they're in the government. And when they switch positions,
it'll be the reverse. But what does that do to the actual ground reality?
Nothing. Now, Mr. Yadav was trying to say, don't point out at, Mr. Prakash was saying, don't point out at the previous regime.
As an example, he said.
Yes. The Forest Department, the Supreme Court of India had stopped the reservation of forest all over India. And even today, that order is in force. And when that order was in force, with the...
Yeah, that guy goes across the board, Anupam.
The problem is, it is not a non-politician who is involved in this. It's only politicians.
Okay, Anupam, the problem also here is there's a genuine problem. There is corruption that happens. Let's not be naive and pretend it doesn't. Do politicians either they're conniving or turning a blind eye? Yes, that happens. Do bureaucrats also do the same thing? Yes, it probably does happen. I don't have evidence of it, so I'm not presenting it on the channel. I can only present you what is happening we've seen on the ground, which is the trucks going in. They're going in open daylight, the animals that have been killed, we have photographs of that, that's the evidence I can present to you, so I'm going to stick to only that. But the reality is, these are genuine problems not just for Karnataka, but for large part of India. What do we do about them to raise them in a national conscience? Because this is important. I mean, next time there's a drought, we'll be kicking ourselves in our backsides.
You see, the attitude has to change. Unfortunately, you know, for the politicians, I mean, people have to now realize that environment has to be made a priority. Now, these animals that are...
Either they're conniving or turning a blind eye, yes, that happens. Do bureaucrats also do the same thing? Yes, it probably does happen. I don't have evidence of it, so I'm not presenting it on the channel. I can only present you what's happening we've seen on the ground, which is the trucks going in. They're going in open daylight. The animals that have been killed, we have photographs of that. That's the evidence I can present to you, so I'm going to stick to only that. But the reality is, these are genuine problems, not just for Karnataka, but for large part of India. What do we do about them to raise them in a national conscience? Because this is important. I mean, next time there's a drought, we'll be kicking ourselves in our backside.
You see, the attitude has to change. Unfortunately, you know, for the politicians, I mean, people have to now realize that environment has to be made a priority. Now, these animals that are being killed, there is also a law, right? Now, if this is an eco-sensitive zone, you cannot have quarrying and mining.
Okay, can I get my producer to pull out the visuals of the trucks? I mean, the trucks are carrying only one thing. If you can pull out the visuals, it'll be in reference context. Yeah, go ahead.
It is terrible. And you see now, this is an elephant corridor which has to be protected. The Supreme Court.
Okay, why don't you tell our viewers who are watching this? Okay, I mean, for more people, yes. Oh, there are tigers and it's a safari place, a tourist attraction. I mean, it doesn't really register when we say save the tiger. It doesn't really. But when we say that Bengaluru is going to be out of water because the aquifer is going to disappear, can you explain that to our viewers who are watching?
Yes. See, certainly. See, everything is interlinked. When you disturb an eco-sensitive zone, then you're not just disturbing the animals therein, you're disturbing the ecology of the region, you're disturbing the flora, the fauna, you're disturbing everything.
You're disturbing yourself.
And ultimately, I'm telling you, all this, yes, right, is going to bite you later, as is already being seen. Now you tell me, if we're not going to be looking at these issues, then tomorrow, what about, you know, rising cases of asthma of people? Now, this area is actually a breathing space, you know.
Yeah, so there is, look, our particulate matter level is so yes, high, and then the politicians will run around. And
then probably some commercial, some industries will start selling those, you know, those masks and everything.
The lakes in Bengaluru. Okay,
yes.
Okay, sir, before I go back to the politicians.
With the growth of Bangalore today, yes, at the rate it is growing, this is the only lung space that will be left.
Correct.
If we let it go.
Okay, but okay. Now some of it is really bad. But I can tell you now. This is right next to Banerghatta. Okay, have a look at this green lung. This is supposed to be. It's not looking very green to me at all. Quickly, your last thoughts on this, Anupam? Then I come to Mr. Abraham. Mr. Prakash, I'll leave the last word with you. Anupam Tripathi. When you see this, what does it make you feel like?
You know, a picture speaks a thousand words. Now you see for yourself where the green lungs, I mean, what has happened to it?
And look at that. I mean, the trucks are all parked there.
It is terrible. And this is an elephant corridor.
Then you see the boards there, which is being, there's the board there. And yes, these are the trucks driving
right
past.
And there have been incidents where leopards have been killed.
They've been run over by the road. Yes, operation. Okay, I'll leave the last word to you, Mr. Prakash. Abraham, when you see these visuals, what is it? Take Mr. Nagaraju Yadav at face value when he says that he's, as a committed Bengalurian, he wants his best for a city. I have no reason to doubt him. But you make a decision. You can make these election issues by having a voice on them to make your politician notice that you really care about what's happening to the green lung of Bengaluru. I'll leave it there. Good night.